Welcome all friends in the Dhamma. Concentration and Vipassana develop together the whole day. When you do your job, you got concentration. You see your job by concentration. Concentration on your job, but you never see yourself how well-being of yourself. You not see how well-being, then you lost all well-being with stress. Okay, very simple. I just today would like to emphasize in daily life. You listen to me, look at me. This is concentration. Okay, but together, see how you doing, how the well-being of yourself. Then it become calm and relaxed. Okay, even you do some Facebook. This is concentration. But can you see how you doing, how you feeling, how well-being or not well-being? This is Vipassana, seeing how well-being of yourself. So that's why in daily life, we bring Samatha and Vipassana, concentration, meditation, and Vipassana, meditation, develop together. Concentration, the whole day you got concentration already. Look at him, look at her, look the way you want to go, but you never see how well-being of yourself, okay? More you see how well-being of yourself, then what you realize? You realize body, the number one body, outside, relax, inside, relax, and four elements feel good of the vital side, okay? Not pain. And more you see how well-being of yourself, you see the body more clearly, then you can see when you got eye contact, ear contact, you got disturbed, then you can see you always lost well-being of your mind with disturbance, okay? Only you see how well-being, how you doing, how you feeling, how you doing, how you feeling, then it can maintain your well-being. You don't have to try to make anything, just see what happening to your cell, your body, your mind, okay? See what happening only. More you see what happening, you get more knowledge, learning. Somebody speak bad, but you still anger, okay? You still angry. Or somebody gossip you also very angry, okay? That means you still a lot of attachment. So more you see how well-being, then you can realize you always lost your well-being with anger, desire, attachment, okay? Then more you see this thing, you can see well-being of body, bring to see well-being of your mental quality, okay? So now, just always see this person, because you come to this life, you can maybe lend this person as a hotel for 80 years. Can you see how well-being of this person? You live in this life 50, 60, 70, 80 years old. Just see well-being, then you will get more understanding. You spoil yourself, okay? You never let go, okay? But if you see what happening to you, you spoil yourself, then just develop loving kindness, okay? What Dhamma will help you got well-being? Oh, let go. Oh, loving kindness. Oh, compassion. Okay? So that's why must see what Dhamma quality you got. But anyhow, today then we start seeing by awareness, see ourselves how we being, seeing master, seeing your friend, seeing the Buddha statue by your eye. Watch, this is concentration. Watch me, listen to my talk. This is concentration. Now you know, if you just develop concentration and inside seeing how we are being, vipassana see yourself, vipassana see yourself together, then you're not lost, okay? You lost because you not see yourself. Nobody tell you, you must see how you're doing, how you're feeling, how we are being. Nobody tell you, you don't know, then you always got eye contact, ear contact, and then you lost in anger, desire, and attachment. So now when you see well-being or not well-being, contemplation, then with contemplation, you can see what is the cause of well-being and what is the cause of not well-being, okay? What is the cause of well-being, what is the cause of not well-being, or what is the cause of suffering, okay? More you see well-being, then something change, not well-being, then because of eye contact, ear contact, and then you think because of he speak back to you, then that is the cause of your suffering, but actually it's not because of people speak back to you, it's because of you got attachment, okay? So this is contemplation. Contemplation. So today we develop seeing things as they really are. How you doing? How you feeling? When you just look at the Buddha statue, Buddha statue not make you angry, okay? Buddha still make you calm and equanimous, okay? And then you can realize more your eye not blur, okay? If your eye got concentration, good concentration on good object, the Buddha statue, okay? Not concentration on your wife, on your husband, sometimes quarreling together. The Buddha statue never make you quarreling, okay? So now you got good object of meditation, and I tell you, you come to this temple, you try, just joy when you see the Buddha statue. Can you see joy, well-being or joy in your heart? Can you see joy? So you know, you don't need to close your eye and do meditation by closing eye because you have a good object. You just do concentration on the Buddha statue, on the smiling face, and see now you got very good well-being when you see the Buddha statue smile. This is very good object, the Buddha statue. And now just concentration on the Buddha statue and see how you feeling, how well-being your mind. Develop contemplation. Contemplation of how your well-being when you see Buddha statue. It's different. If you contemplation on your well-being, seeing Buddha statue, but now seeing somebody else, you can realize your well-being may be lost, okay? But when you come to see the Buddha statue, watch and observe the Buddha statue, how smiling, how posture, how calm the Buddha statue, can you develop seeing with contemplation the Buddha statue and contemplation of how your well-being, can you? This is vipassana, contemplation of body and body in the body. Body outside, sitting this way, sitting this way, body inside, got well-being, all the vital side works nicely, gently, when see the Buddha statue. And with seeing more the Buddha statue smiling, how you see the well-being, not only the body, but well-being of your mind. So I just let you, maybe you come to temple. Before you crossing eye, you just watch the Buddha statue with smile first. It will help you got more absorption with bliss and joy, because you can see and realize the smiling face of the Buddha. I can realize the smiling face of Buddha now. I feel good. And see how we're being. Getting more and more well-being. Getting more and more well-being. And what happening with getting more and more and well-being? Breathing nicely, gently. And you got bliss and joy in your heart. And now, see how your well-being the whole day. But now you look at the Buddha statue, 2-3 minutes. The Buddha statue, more you do concentration on Buddha statue more and more, you turn inwards with well-being. You realize turning inwards of your mind with well-being. And with well-being, you can develop contemplation of what mental quality and how sensual pleasure. It becomes wholesome feeling. Wake up, wake up. And also now, when you got wholesome feeling, joy and bliss, this is body inside, you got joy and bliss. Or mental quality inside, you got joy and bliss. Can you contemplate all together? When you got joy and bliss, body outside, relax. And breathing is a part of body, very nice and gentle. So today, I would like you to develop contemplation of the whole well-being. That means relaxing, breathing nicely, and vital side inside, very smooth, not fluctuated, very good. Now can you see with contemplation? First I tell you see well-being. But today I would like you to see with contemplation. Not by eye. By eye see the Buddha statue, but see how we are being with contemplation, then you can see more. That is, you can see well-being of body and well-being of your mind, how sensual pleasure, joy and happiness. This, you get more wisdom, seeing all mental phenomena as arising, disappearing, it's changing. You get calm and more calmness and more calmness. You see the Buddha statue smiling face, you get joy, joy and more joy and bliss and gladness. You can see more well-being, okay? Of wholesome, more wholesome. Then more wholesome until become neutral mind, okay? Become equality of mind. So the point is, we go to the neutral mind, that is the access on the path to enlightenment, okay? Equality of mind. but before we can realize the quantity of mind, you contemplate of how well-being of body and mind, and more how well-being you can realize joy and happiness and bliss and more bliss and gladness, then equality of mind wake up. Equality of mind never wake up because you got anger, desire, delusion, but instead you just develop more seeing well-being of body first. More well-being of body you see more and more, then you can see more well-being of your mind. More and more see well-being of your mind, then it turn inwards and wake up with joy, happiness, bliss, and gladness. Then equality of my open and wake up. Okay? If your mind not well-being, still sad, how you go to equality of mind? Okay? You must see more well-being. How to see more well-being? You need a good object of meditation, the Buddha statue, because the Buddha statue smile. Okay? Okay? Or maybe you see the nature. The nature make you feel good or not? Whatever you see and make you feel good or well-being, then it go more well-being, become joy, happiness, bliss, gladness, then equality of mind. Okay? The way, going on to the way to enlightenment, we develop bliss and gladness first. That's why I always tell you to smile and feel your smile, awareness of your smile. Even people speak not good, speak bad, never mind. I have my smile at home. Okay? Smile, gladness, and joy and happiness. And then it becomes open more consciousness, clear consciousness with equality of mind. This is the well-being of your mind, okay? Yesterday, I just tell you to develop vipassana, seeing the whole well-being of body, and then you can see relaxation of the whole body in outside and vital side inside, when you got well-being of body, okay? And then it bring you to calm down, calm and quiet and seclusion, because you got well-being of your body. But today I'm teaching you more seeing well-being of your mind. More you see well-being of body, then you can realize your mind getting more well-being, joy, happiness, bliss, and gladness, more bliss and gladness. That is the way open or equality of mind already there. And then with equality of mind, you just regarding your body, your sensation, your thought. In equality of mind, you not involved. When you regard thing, you can realize it come, it's arising and disappearing. Okay? Thought arising, disappearing. If you can stay equanimity in your mind, you can see eye contact arising, disappearing, ear contact arising, disappearing, sensual pleasure arising, disappearing, thought arising, disappearing. That's why, are you able to stay conscious in neutral mind for long time? In the beginning, you cannot. You can stay conscious in neutral mind only 5 seconds, 10 seconds. It's difficult, quite difficult, because you always stay with desire, you stay with anger, and you don't know how to stay with equality of mind. How to stay with equality of mind? you must develop joy, happiness, bliss, and gladness with loving kindness and with all wholesome feeling in your heart. But before you develop wholesome feeling in your heart, you must see how well-being of your heart first. Then you will know how you can develop more well-being and let go of all attachment, okay? And how you can see well-being of your mind more and more, you need to see well-being of body first, okay? So that's why the Buddha tell us mindfulness of body and body in the body, or the whole well-being of body outside and inside. Outside, relax. Inside, all vital signs, heartbeat, pulsation, temperature is really nice. Okay, that's it. Look like when you sit on the beach, you can realize the well-being of body outside, relaxing, and inside, very nice with all vital side, smooth working, not strong, not fast, pulsation not too fast, heartbeat not too fast, it's just moderate and it feel calm and cool. So now you just see good object of meditation, the nature or the Buddha statue, then you can realize all well-being. More we realize your well-being, then you got self-awareness of bliss and joy and gladness and self-awareness of equality of mind. I use the word self-awareness because you cannot make self, you cannot make your mind equality, cannot. It become happen by itself if you just see how well-being, how joy, happiness, how happiness, gladness, more and more, then it happens by itself. You take the quality of mind. You can realize when you got joy, happiness, and bliss, and gladness, it become intuitive awareness. Wow! Freedom of mind. Sometimes. Okay? So this is we call Dhamma eye wake up, but it's not fulfillment wake up. It's only a bit, and then go down again. Okay, a bit. So just see well-being of body first, okay, and connect to see well-being of your mind together. See well-being of body and mind for this session, and not only practicing meditation, more and more in daily life. Because you don't know the most happiness is the well-being of body and mind. Okay? You find money, you find a car, buy a big house, you have plenty of money, it doesn't mean it's the most happiness. Okay? Most happiness is well-being of your body and mind. So before you get enlightened, just go to the most happiness well-being of body and mind first. Well-being. And when you got well-being of body and mind, we start with body first. You see well-being of body outside, inside. But if you can see well-being of outside, inside, relaxation and inside, seeing more with contemplation, you can see 5 aggregate. Well-being will help you get more conscious seeing the 5 aggregate of body and mind. Okay? That is where you only see how well-being of body really, really easy. But I tell you, seeing well-being of body with contemplation. What you see with contemplation, well-being of body, you see four elements. Okay? Can you realize four elements? Or can you realize the vital sign? All the vital sign, that is the functioning of the four elements. So now you got more mindfulness with contemplation of well-being generally first, but in general, more contemplation, more contemplation. You can see the four elements. And what you see the four elements? Arising and disappearing. All four elements arising, disappearing. Arising, disappearing. Seeing by contemplation more, you can see this body, you cannot regard this body as you or your, because it's the body of four elements, not of you, of four elements, okay? So this is the wisdom, because not many people can see himself as four elements, okay? So my master said, now you contemplate this body, well-being, you can see four elements, seeing this body as four elements, then you have breakfast. Who eating? Four elements eating four elements. 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 No cell at all. Because you never see this body as four elements, then you only see, I am eating, I am eating. But it's not you, four elements, okay? More you can see this body as four elements. Four elements talk to four elements. Four elements talk to four elements. More you can see four elements talk to four elements, you can see the function of four elements got five functions of five aggregates. You see this body at four elements first, you can see the function of four elements into five aggregates or five groups. The first aggregate is form. Okay? Hardness, softness of body, earth element, we can see it makes form. Okay? It makes posture. Second function, it got sensation, okay? Sensual pressure, okay? And it got the third aggregate is perception, okay? And the fourth one is thought, and the fifth one is conscious element, okay? So from four elements, you can see six elements. Four elements, earth element, fire element, water element, and consciousness element. Consciousness element and emptiness element. Okay? More you see four elements, you can see wake up of consciousness element. Wow! In four elements, behind the scene is consciousness element and emptiness element. Okay? Behind the scene. So, we are six elements. Okay? Because we are human beings. Okay? We got consciousness as well. Now, we got seeing inward into consciousness element. Then inside you never see consciousness element, then it becomes subconscious. More you see conscious element, more and more wake up to eye contact, become eye consciousness. To ear contact, become ear consciousness. Okay? To nose contact, nose consciousness. Tongue consciousness. Okay? And body consciousness. Now you know the clear mind, the conscious element never wake up before, because it got stuck in sensual pleasure, sensation element got stuck in perception element, not element, perception aggregate, sensual aggregate, and thought aggregate. Then consciousness become aggregate because it hold with sensation aggregate, perception aggregate, and thought aggregate. But when you got seeing bliss and joy and equality of mind from consciousness aggregate that sleeping inside the subconscious, become wake up with consciousness element. The knowledge wake up, intuitive awareness wake up. Okay? So now you can rely. Now you got not enough power to wake up consciousness element. But I will give you technique to learn how to wake up. Now your awareness of body very poor. But if I tell you, lean backwards, your back, slowly. Consciousness element come to help you. Hey, enough, no more, otherwise you falling. How you know enough, no more? Consciousness element. And then you can rely in daily life. You always, not always, sometimes got consciousness element. You don't know what to do, but you got ping idea. Oh, this is the way to solve the problem. Okay? Intuition wake up. You don't know what to do or what not to do. But sometimes you got calmness and it come up and it tell you, do it, okay? And this, before it come with wisdom, with wisdom tell you, do it or not do it, wake it up first with consciousness by awareness of body. Lean your back backwards. It become more power of awareness, and then this your master will tell you what to do, how to do, what not to do. It look like your master sometimes communicate to you. Not think that way. You got intuitive awareness or not? Not think that way. This is come from consciousness element. Okay. But consciousness element not enough power because you sit and you lost with thought and sit and with desire, ignorance. You go into subconscious. Then I tell you, just now more awareness of body bring up consciousness, come to body first. How? Lean backwards slowly again. All darkness gone, the light come up. That's right. This is what you can see some book use the word intuitive awareness. Okay? Intuitive awareness. Okay? You can realize, I can realize this book. Many masters try to explain about intuitive awareness. Okay? By wording. But I explain to you by action. Okay? Action. Okay? This is intuitive awareness. This is the keyword of enlightenment. Who enlightenment? Not you. Consciousness element. Wake up. Or let's use the word intuitive awareness or intuitive knowledge. Now when you got sitting this way and so comfortable, no intuitive awareness because you just lost with joy, and now you have to develop joy, happiness, and then wake up with gladness. Okay, people always lost with joy and happiness. So that's why I tell you, develop joy, happiness, bliss, and gladness. Okay. In samatha meditation, you got stuck in joy and happiness. Okay. How to develop happiness to become blissful and become gladness. Okay. It look like when you got gladness, intuition wake up, and this intuition is the knowledge. Will tell you what to do, what not to do. Sometimes the first answer, how are you today? How are you? I'm fine. This is from intuition. Okay, I'm fine. you say from intuitive awareness, but after that, I'm not sure. I am so busy now. It's not intuition anymore. The first answer is intuition. So today I just realized the intuition. It wake up, not can say not wake up, really not wake up. Or one day maybe a little wake up, okay? But if you got mindful walking, mindful sitting, this is mindful, but more mindfulness now, lean backwards. When you are going to falling, it stop or not? This is intuitive awareness that you can see many master try to explain by word in the book. Name of the book, intuitive awareness, okay? Intuitive knowledge, or clear knowledge, or clear knowing, okay? This thing. And now, can you try? Just get experience, lean backwards your back. Wake up, yeah, wake up, otherwise you're falling, okay? And now, it wake up already? Wake up with seeing how well-being of this body and mind, okay? And wake up with contemplation. How this body only four elements. Contemplation by awareness. It can see into four elements. And more, wake up with contemplation of this body, how well-being. It's four elements and five aggregate. People don't know. They try to develop reflection. Reflection, this body, four elements, just thinking. It's not intuition. Okay? People just only develop reflection. But vipassana jnana, the Dhamma eye, is the intuition one. Seeing by itself, knowing by itself, intuition, wake up. Okay, so if you can realize intuitive awareness wake up now when you walk in a hurry, this your knowledge will realize you, will remind you walk slowly, walk mindfully. So this one very difficult to explain, very difficult. We call intuitive awareness. But today I just tell you, first, mindfulness, seeing the whole well-being of body first. Next, connect to mindfulness, seeing the whole well-being of body and mind. Then, with joy, happiness, bliss, and gladness, Superman wake up. Wake up. You know. All in the knowing of consciousness. When it wake up. Sitting in the knowing of consciousness. Not of your brain. Sitting in the knowing of consciousness. When it wake up. Walking in the knowing of consciousness. And more you knowing with consciousness. It become more Dhamma eye. Okay? Wisdom eye wake up. Okay? So now it look like intuition wake up when you play sport. For example, play golf. And see the distance. Intuition. That's right. You can realize this is good. Because you have to develop your concentration, see 100 yards, 150 yards, and then feeling and aware, feeling and aware, feeling and hit. So that's why, and you walk on the top yard, very beautiful, feel good, happy. Then this is good for intuitive awareness, okay? That's why if you rely this intuitive awareness, wow, this is, if you develop more, it's like you are seeing this person only four elements. Okay, when you regard yourself, now I'm playing golf, I'm playing golf. You got desire, you got expectation, you surrender. Okay, but if you just exercise four elements, okay? Four element hitting, four element play golf, very good. Good result, okay? So now, can you see this four element breathing? With contemplation together? So that's why the Buddha used the word contemplation of body and body in the body, contemplation of sensation and sensation in sensation, contemplation of mind in the mind, contemplation of mental quality and mental quality in the mental quality. Use the word contemplation. But in the beginning, you don't know how to develop contemplation. Then I just tell you mindfulness of body, mindfulness of sensation, mindfulness of mind, mindfulness of mental quality. But now you know, if you got mindfulness well, you need to develop contemplation because you know, when you take off, you are not looking at the ball. No! Your intuition wake up the knower, become conscious. Okay? We call the knower, the seer. Now, you rely or not, the knower, seer. This is physical eye seeing 100 yards. This is the knower seer seeing how hard you hit the golf. How hard. Or only not far. Then you see from the knower and seer. Okay? So that's why today we will develop this knower, the seer. See your body. What you can see from the knower and seer. You can see and know stomach movement. Okay? Can you see? Rising, falling. But not only the stomach, the muscle. And the whole rising, falling, we call arising disappearing arising disappearing arising disappearing when you can develop seeing arising disappearing more intuitive awareness wake up you don't have to play God don't have to okay you don't have to play God so today we just develop mindfulness seeing the whole well-being body and whole well-being of mind with joy, happiness, bliss and gladness, then it got intuitive awareness open and wake up. And when it's open, when it wake up in the beginning, what it see, what it know? It know movement. Okay. It know rising, falling, or it know arising, disappearing, arising, disappearing. So, the enlightened one, the first monk who got listening to the Buddha Dhamma and become the first monk, the enlightened monk, the first one is Anyakonthanya. His name Anyakonthanya. What he got enlightened? He see this body arising, disappearing, arising, disappearing, arising, disappearing. From nowhere, seer here. But your nowhere seer always separated. Nowhere maybe still here. But seer go to thought. Then you lose seeing inside. Or maybe you know but you cannot see. That's why you need to focus to see something, then calm down the mind here, then it come here. When you got thought, you got the seer, the mind separated from the knower, heart is the knower, and the mind always come to your brain with thought. Okay? So today I will let you do concentration from here. How can you start simple exercise? What can you know easily? What part of body, if you know from here? Rising, falling of stomach, rising, falling of muscle, that's right. You know this is very we call the access to open up. If you see from this mind and heart become one, it become the door open, okay? So today, calm down your mind by see the whole well-being of body and see the whole well-being of mind. Your mind always stay in the office, this is office, this is home. When you see the whole well-being of body, see the whole well-being of mind, then your mind come back home with heart, mind and heart become one. Mind and heart become one, it become intuitive awareness. Awareness, body, rising, falling. Even you look at me, listen to my talk, how you know from your mind and heart become one together. What part of body you know rising, falling? Stomach. That's right. Muscle. So today we develop mindfulness, awareness from mind and heart become one. But mindfulness, listen to my talk. This is from your brain, okay? Your brain, your ear, your eye, look and listen at me mindfully. look and listen something outside mindfully but your heart your mind and your heart when become one can know and see directly your stomach rising falling your muscle rising falling your breathing in God all the whole body rising falling how you know rising falling not from your brain but you know from directly from mind and heart here that's right now this is very advanced okay because okay first you just calm down your mind okay or empty your mind then you got calmness but in the calmness if you got more you can develop joy and bliss in your heart then your mind and your heart anchor with joy and bliss then it become I knowing from here seeing from here now smile now in your heart when you smile can you know stomach rising falling from smiling heart huh your physical eye seeing me your smiling heart see movement of stomach that's right this is very important so when you delight this mind and heart become I that mean you got well-being of your mind not separated okay now I tell you I would like you let you learn about well-being of your mind because your mind always sometimes go this way your heart go this way your mind go this way your heart go this way even you practice meditation your mind your heart your mind go to your brain because you focus your breathing your mind come here this is not well-being already you got ten okay but if your mind stay with your heart you get attention attention or good attention attention good good attention on breathing can you this is we call attention okay your eye look at me your ear listen to my talk can you keep attention on your breathing from heart knowing from heart seeing from heart can you keep attention on how breathing in how breathing out doesn't matter long or short so this is attention when you got attention then you not only see breathing in breathing out attention become dhamma eye seeing defilement seeing kilesa or desire attachment more then it become less if you focus from your brain your eye desire more it become more anger more then it not reduce it not release because you focus okay but if you see with intuition and keep attention on breathing as home attention anchor with breathing mind and heart always stay here when mind and heart stay here it got good quality of knowing and seeing inwards okay so now keep attention no I not tell you now focus your breathing when I tell you focus your breathing your mind come here and focus breathing so today just focus the Buddha statue but can you also keep attention knowing how you are breathing in or out can you keep attention and knowing now you are breathing in or breathing out You not only knowing, but you got seeing. So today, knowing and seeing from mindfulness inside. This we call mindfulness inside. Okay? Attention. Because when you got mindfulness inside, you got good attention on breathing, knowing now, breathing in or breathing out, breathing long or breathing short. When you knowing from here, it's not only knowing breathing, it's knowing the mind itself, okay? It's knowing into the mind itself, okay? It's knowing into the mental phenomena itself, happen by itself, okay? That is subconsciousness open, because you develop mindfulness in subconsciousness. Okay? Now your eye with me, but keep attention on body first. When you keep attention knowing how your body movement, got movement, can you know and see from heart? Can you know and see? Okay? Can you know and see? And now keep attention on the whole bodily movement. What you see? Rising, falling, arising, disappearing, arising, disappearing. So today, develop more vipassana in your mind. First, we develop vipassana, seeing body, the whole well-being, okay? And we connect to our mind, the whole well-being of body and mind. And now at the mind, we develop intuition, awareness, consciousness element, okay? And then consciousness element, then anchor with joy and bliss and gladness. It become eye opening here. And eye opening here, when you got eye contact, ear contact, desire arising, it knowing desire instantly. Okay? You got anger before you got desire, you not know instantly because your mindfulness not inside. But you can see now you got anger. But if you got mindfulness here together, anger arising, you know instantly. Okay? And when you know instantly, anger disappearing. Desire arising, desire disappearing. So, just knowing inside, keep knowing inside, keep seeing inside of mental quality, okay? But anchor your knowing with bliss and gladness. And with bliss and gladness, what happening? You got knowing automatically, breathing nicely, gently into your heart. Before you do concentration of breathing, you only focus breathing into your lung, okay? But today you know and seeing from your heart, then it got knowing, breathing nicely, gently, deeply into your spiritual, okay? That's why now you're breathing, you knowing from here, then it go into your spiritual. And with the breathing go into your spiritual, you can realize something, or mental phenomena, or defilement, or small defilement inside, all the cause of suffering is your attachment inside, okay? So today, open eye, and if you want to develop more knowing, seeing from here, you must open eye in the beginning, 2-3 minutes. Because when you close your eye, then it come here. It come here, you can see breathing in and out inside the nostril. But cannot see breathing go in into your heart to your spiritual you cannot say okay now smiling and joy and bliss and anchor your mind with breathing is open and more consciousness consciousness knowing in the consciousness okay and knowing in the consciousness when you got eye contact in the consciousness you got perception you got attachment you are very selfish you are very attached or clinging okay and you feel happy inside okay you feel disturbed inside but anchor this you need home you are knower need breathing as home okay just awareness of breathing as home and now this session seeing the whole well-being of body first seeing the whole well-being of body and mind and the whole well-being of mind with joy or not then joy and bliss or not joy and bliss and gladness or not if not develop loving kindness then you got equality of mind awareness rising falling of stomach muscle the whole body rising falling including breathing in and pause knowing from here you can know breathing every moment that mean knowing breathing and pause pausing breathing and pausing breathing and pausing breathing and pausing okay and more pausing you are your heart open your spiritual wake up and just anchor your mind your heart with breathing and bliss and gladness together then you got attention from your heart seeing how breathing how feeling and how the well-being of your knower and seer Even you got calmness of thought, but the knower inside still got disturbing a bit, agitation a bit. You can rely mind and heart not become one. Then you need smile, loving kindness, bliss and gladness. Then it become equality of mind and in equality of mind knowing attentively on breathing as whole knowing and seeing you got knowing and seeing and together you got contemplation of breathing and the whole body movement or the whole body rising falling or arising disappearing. So stay knowing in the knowing, knowing in knowing, knowing in the knowing with seeing, knowing in the knowing with seeing. That is clear mind. Knowing in the knowing with seeing. Then you got seeing arising disappearing. Arising, disappearing, arising, disappearing, more you know, more you see, all attachment release. And you can see releasement with clear mind with bliss and grandeur. Anchor your mind and your heart with bliss and grandeur. And contemplation of how your mind, your heart become one or sometimes not become one. Because you got perception, desire inside, your mind always running out. Okay? Can you see your mind sometimes running out or start running out? Then just mindfulness outside of the whole body, see the whole well-being together. When you can see the whole well-being of body from mindfulness regarding the body foundation, then you can see the whole well-being of your mind regarding mental quality foundation. Knowing in the knowing with seeing together before you knowing in the brain. Now knowing in your heart, knowing in the knowing, then you can see the quality of knowing, more quality of knowing with bliss and gladness. You can rely equality of mind. Oh, no self at all is the shunyata, emptiness of self. And develop outside mindfulness, contemplation, the whole well-being together. Today we learn how to wake up your knowing and seeing inside with mindfulness and awareness inside. But you still need to develop together in parallel mindfulness and awareness outside, seeing the whole well-being of the body. So can you develop outside and inside together? Open eye, easy. Open eye, you always can see the whole well-being of this person. Very easy to see the whole well-being of this body. Then just develop more awareness from inside. Awareness near to your heart, stomach movement. Awareness near to your heart, sensation inside. Awareness near to your heart inside, the mental phenomena. Okay. But you need supporting by mindfulness awareness outside, seeing the whole well-being, then it will be connect to well-being of your mind, and then you can learn to know and see from awareness in your mind, knowing things as they really are, knowing in the knowing still got desire, in the knowing still got attachment, but you need the power of mindfulness on the body foundation, seeing the whole well-being of body, and especially the whole well-being of body inside the vital side. Now you just learn to see the well-being of body inside or the vital side. Then together, the novel knowing arising disappearing of vital side. And that is knowing things arising, things disappearing, very instantly. Things arising, things disappearing, things arising, things disappearing. Then you can know by more awareness of your life energy on the vital side. Only arising, disappearing. Or in the beginning, you know your body into four elements. Warm and cool and warm. Then when you can see the warm and cool from mindfulness outside, seeing the whole well-being, then it will wake up the knower here. When the knower here, then it become more conscious. More conscious, and then it more conscious with seeing suchness, we call suchness, okay? Seeing suchness, okay? Seeing suchness that you see all together, outside, inside, with knowing and with seeing and understanding. Now, even you open eye, you got seeing the whole well-being of body and mind. And in the mind, you got knowing, in the mind, knowing in the knowing. From gladness, bliss and gladness, more bliss and gladness now. It more turn inwards, seeing all mental phenomena, or any desire inside you can turn inwards and see. And then it release. It release, and then you get more knowledge or intuitive knowledge. Why you got desire for 40, 50, 60, 70 years, but now you know how to release. Before you know from your thought, your brain, you cannot release desire and attachment. This can help you see calmness. Calmness and the well-being, okay? When you can see the well-being, then more gladness, turn inwards, more mindfulness going inside with awareness, knowing in the knowing, what in the knowing you got? Mental phenomena, perception, okay? And it also arising, disappearing. It got vibration. You got swaying, Iresa, you see Iresa. Before you not see swaying, because you blinded with desire. Before desire, it fall in love first. It fall in love first. Now you can see you fall in love. Okay. So now just start from here. Mindfulness outside, seeing the whole well-being of body and mind. And now we practice now. And start from here, and develop mindfulness and power of awareness by lean backwards. Wow. Inside, open with eye inside. Oh, on release already, because you wake up outside more and more, okay? That's why you can realize when you got stuck in thought or desire. Normally you have to go exercise, walk in the garden, or walk in the nature to relax your mind. But now, no garden, you stay at home. Oh, too much disturb. Just lean back your back backwards slowly. Wake up already, okay? All disturbance, stress, desire gone because you not go to fight with desire, but you wake up, come to body foundation, awareness of bodily movement, especially turn back. And then it comes awareness of body, it forget anger, forget desire, it comes here. Then you can see if you not attached or just forget something, not always attached or always remember. Sometimes you need forget something. How to forget? Not forget in your brain. Forget with attachment, come to the body. Okay? Or more forget something, then you can understand. Oh, just let go, not attached. Now, you got consciousness element, seeing body, seeing thought. It become three dimension. Okay? Before you got only two dimension, mind, seeing body. Okay, this is in the beginner, but more you wake up, consciousness element, come up. Then you know, where is your home? Your home is here, okay? PMI is here, consciousness, seeing monkey mind, seeing body, consciousness, seeing mind and body. My master just write meditation book. Inside meditation, just tell how you develop consciousness. Wake up from monkey mind. Monkey mind here and here. Here is easy, but here you need more awareness. Then it become Dhamma eye, seeing body and mind. And this consciousness, it become Dhamma eye or knowledge. It got knowledge. Then the last minute, you got to pass away. Just you stay on bed in the hospital. Just wake up your consciousness. You can move your neck. Okay? You are ready? Tonight, not over the midnight, you go to next slide, okay? Here. And here, can see the path to the next slide, okay? Because it become consciousness, see body and mind, not lost in formation of mind anymore. Free your mind, free to your consciousness. And this will go to the high level, okay? And more this power of awareness, you can make your aim, your right determination, come to Perth again, the next slide. Come to Thailand, come to Buddhism, become monk again, okay? So now, open eye. Now you need eye consciousness. Take picture. This is your eye, look my camera. One. When I count two, you got eye consciousness. See your smiling on your face, can you see? Wake up already. You don't need to lean back your backwards. Don't need to lean backwards your back. You only. One, two. See your face. Can you see your face? You have maybe only 2 seconds before the king of death come to you. Only 2-3 seconds. Okay? You need skill. Just when you are going to die, but you got knowing now, near to death. Even you now, you close your eye, but your eye consciousness still can see your facial feeling or not? And now we will develop insight from consciousness of body and mind and eye. Even you close your eye, more seeing with eye consciousness, your facial feeling, then you can see the whole body feeling. Just turn inwards, sensing your facial feeling. What turn inwards? Eye consciousness. Before you close your eye, you never see your facial feeling. So this session, just wake up eye consciousness, seeing yourself, the whole body well-being, and the whole well-being of your face with smile. Then you got more consciousness in your heart. Wake up more and more. Seeing your consciousness on your facial feeling, or sensing consciousness on your facial feeling, or send the whole well-being of consciousness now, sensing the whole well-being of consciousness of the whole body and of your face. With contemplation, see what's going on. Now seeing the whole well-being of your consciousness, overall consciousness, including your face consciousness as well. Can you see the whole well-being or not? Consciousness well-being is your clear mind. all in the knowing of consciousness. If you got whole well-being of consciousness, it got automatic knowing in the consciousness. Breathing nicely, gently, and knowing this body just four element. In consciousness can be like four element. Breathing is air element. In consciousness can realize four element and realize consciousness element itself together. Then you got consciousness element wake up more and more. Knowing in consciousness, seeing in consciousness, seeing the whole well-being of consciousness, knowing the whole well-being of not of consciousness, then consciousness become wake up consciousness, seeing body and mind. You got three dimensions now. And now you got back home. Your home is consciousness. Just know what you know in consciousness. See what you see in consciousness. Know what you know, the whole well-being of consciousness more and more. It got into both jhana and dhyana. It got into absorption more into the jhana state with jhana or knowledge, seeing clearly the whole well-being of body, mind, and consciousness together. Now you can see the whole well-being of body, mind, and consciousness. With contemplation, you can see clearly. And the whole well-being of consciousness, that is neutral mind, equality of mind. No self not involved at all. All the clear mind, all the oneness, all the one mind. Not any disturbance anymore. That is the liberation mind, okay? What liberation? Consciousness liberated from monkey mind, okay? Because consciousness wake up, see body and mind. And consciousness always stay conscious of body and see the formation of mind become release, 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 and liberation. Finally. Seeing the well-being of consciousness with contemplation more and more. Then something maybe got disturbed a bit, or formation of thought a bit, or any delusion a bit, clear out and become wake up. And freedom, okay? That is mind knowing the mind. Consciousness knowing in the consciousness. Because the residue of defilement is still got attachment in consciousness. Okay? Knowing the well-being of body first, and the mind, and then the consciousness. Then you can clean your mind, clear your mind, clear your consciousness. And then it becomes conscious element, light, spotlight, sensing, 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 before it becomes aggregate. Because it got attachment. Now it free from sensation aggregate, then it become more element. It free from perception aggregate, it become more consciousness element. It free from sankhara aggregate or thought aggregate, it become element, consciousness element. Now you got consciousness some element. The knower is the conscious element. All the object, body, my object or phenomena. Because the consciousness element, it arising, disappearing also, it intuition. Wake up and see, wake up and see, wake up and see. Then it can see all, everything arising, disappearing, arising, disappearing. And now just stay conscious, you know, consciousness, seeing the well-being, the whole well-being of consciousness, just seeing the whole well-being of consciousness, then you know how to stay conscious and not involved. Not involved your mind, your body. Just see the way it is, your body and mind, okay? It arising, disappearing, arising, disappearing, and stay there. And just review your practice, how understanding, how knowing clearly, seeing clearly, knowing what, seeing what, knowing and seeing three dimensions, knowing, seeing body sitting this way, knowing, seeing still got thought a bit, or got any delusion, and knowing, seeing clear mind itself, just review. Knowing in the knowing, knowing in the knowing. Before you got knowing in thought, now knowing in the knowing of clear consciousness. And just reveal how you wake up with mindfulness, awareness, and consciousness. And with bliss and joy more and more, clear consciousness become more wake up. Then you got sensing. Sensing from the consciousness element. So now you know, I ask the question, how much do you send yourself in a day? You never, because your consciousness element never wake up. Okay? Today your consciousness element wake up like spotlight. How much do you send in a day? You know how send yourself. Send your thought, send your delusion, send your bodily movement. Okay? So now your homework, more sensing yourself the four foundation. Before you, more mindfulness of the four foundation. Mindfulness of body, mindfulness of sensation, mindfulness of my activity, mindfulness of mental quality. But now mindfulness and awareness with sensing. Now sensing the bodily movement, bodily action, sensing with knowing and seeing, without thought, okay? Knowing, seeing your bodily movement, sensing your sensual pleasure, without any any expectation, without any desire, okay, and sensing your mind activity, desire, attachment, anger, and sensing into mental phenomena, okay, you still got mental phenomena, it got make you delusion, ignorant mental phenomena, now sensing it disappear, now you wake up, and this is when you wake up more, you enlighten, seeing all arising disappearing, things arising disappearing, things arising disappearing, okay, regarding body, sensation, mind object, all decides, all arising disappearing, thing arising disappearing, thing arising disappearing, even the consciousness itself arising disappearing. This is the first enlightened Sodaban, seeing arising disappearing, said by the first Sodaban in Buddhism. He is the Anya Kotanya, his name Anya Kotanya, on Asaraha Puja, the full moon day, there are five follower of the Buddha, the first five follower, okay, the first follower, and one is the Anya Kotanya, got enlightened with Sodaban, with Dhamma eye, seeing things arising and disappearing, seeing from consciousness, seeing thing arising, disappearing, regarding body, sensation, mind, and mind object. And now just share it to everybody in your family, everybody in the country with loving kindness and compassion. Smile to yourself for your good health, happiness, and all success. And we finish this session. Sathu, sathu, sathu. Buddhang saranang kacchami.ดัมมังสารนังคัจฉามิสังฆังสารนังคัจฉามิ May the Buddha, Dhamma, and Sangha protect you and your family with good health and all well-being with Dhamma and this very life. Sathu, sathu, sathu.